This is a simple science fair project to show how water expands when it's heated. So basically, we're going to take a plastic bottle, fill it with some water, add some food coloring, and then we'll put a straw through the bottle cap down into the water. After that, we'll take a lamp and we'll shine it on the bottle, and the water will warm up. If the water expands, if it undergoes thermal expansion, it's going to have to go somewhere, and up the straw is the only option it has. So our data is going to be how much the water rises in the straw. Pretty simple, right? But to really impress the judges at a science fair, or to impress your science teacher at school, you need to have a topic that's interesting and important. And this is why thermal expansion of water is important. There's a lot of water on our planet. In fact, about 70% of the Earth is covered by water. So if the average temperature on Earth increases, then the water is going to expand and it will occupy more volume. But like the water in the bottle, it has to go somewhere. And that somewhere is over islands and up the coasts. And this is what we call sea level rise. Sea level rise is a slow process, but it's happening right now, and the sea will continue to rise. And thermal expansion of water is a major factor in sea level rise. So that's what makes this project interesting and important, and that's what will make your work stand out, because many people don't realize that thermal expansion is an important factor in rising sea levels. So my hypothesis might be, if water is heated, then it will expand to occupy more volume, and then I could test that. So to test that, I took a 750 milliliter Dr. Pepper bottle, a 2 liter bottle would work as well, and I drilled a hole in the cap of the bottle so a straw just squeezes through. Then I sealed around the bottle cap to make sure that no water could leak out. I used a hot glue gun, but caulk or waterproof sealant would work just as well. So I filled my bottle with water, I put in some dark food coloring, and then I put the cap on, made sure that the water was up a little bit in the straw. Before I turned the lamp on, I collected data as to how high the water was in the straw. Then I shined an incandescent bulb, those are the ones that get hot, on the bottle. You could use a thermometer in the bottle if you wanted to collect temperature data, but to minimize materials, I just measured how high the water went in the straw, and I did that every 15 minutes. So here's a few data points. We have our initial data point before we turn the light on. 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 60 minutes, and then all the way out to 2 hours. At that point, I had to stop because it was about to overflow. Two things to note. One is if nothing happens, you turn the light on and the water doesn't rise, you probably have a leak. So you want to make sure that there are no leaks. Even a tiny leak can cause problems. The other thing is, you may want to have a control group. This is an identical bottle with the straw and the bottle cap and the food coloring and water, but you don't put it under the lamp. You still collect data, but what it shows you is that if nothing happens in the control, that the lamp is really what's causing the water to get warmer and to expand. You should follow the format provided by the science fair or by your teacher to write the project up. But remember, what's interesting here, in addition to your data and how you present that, are the implications for your project. If you can discuss how sea level rise relates to the work that you've done, how your bottle with a straw and the water is a model for sea level rise, that will really make your work stand out. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.